إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله، اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، هل سألت نفسك يوما ما هذا السؤال؟ هل تحب لقاء الله سبحانه وتعالى أم لا؟ اعلموا أنكم ملاقوا الله سبحانه وتعالى إن آجلا أو عاجلا. آخر ما نزل من القرآن كان: واتقوا يوما ترجعون فيه إلى الله ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون. Have you ever asked yourself this question? Do you look forward to meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Do you love meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We are going to meet Allah willingly or unwillingly. Inevitably we will meet Allah sooner or later. The last that was revealed in the Quran in Surah Al-Baqarah, وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا تُرْجَعُونَ فِيهِ إِلَى اللَّهِ. And fear a day when you will return back to Allah, ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت, and each soul will be recompensed for what it has earned. ثم توفى كل نفس ما كسبت وهم لا يظلمون, and no injustice whatsoever. No injustice on the day of judgment. Rest assured, because the judge is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يَظْلِمُ رَبُّكَ أَحَدًا. And Allah will never deal with anyone unjustly. It's absolute justice on the day of judgment. So rest assured, but the question is, do we really look forward to meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? If you do, here's the good news. مَنْ أَحَبَّ لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ أَحَبَّ اللَّهُ لِقَاءَهُ وَمَنْ كَرِهَ لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ كَرِهَ اللَّهُ لِقَاءَهُ. Whoever looks forward to meeting Allah, Allah will look forward to meeting him. Whoever does not look forward to meeting Allah, or dislikes meeting Allah, or hates meeting Allah, Allah will hate meeting him. It is not hate or love that Allah treats us. When we love meeting Allah, it's different when Allah looks forward to meeting us. Allah meets us with mercy, with forgiveness, with rewards. But when with you, you look forward to meeting your Lord. And don't be afraid, don't be worried, because you are coming to Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Allah, the merciful, the most compassionate. So when you look forward to meeting Allah, Allah will look forward to meeting you. And the only way to meet Allah is you have to cross a bridge. That bridge that will reach you, that will enable you to reach to Allah, which is death. We will have to die. We will die sooner or later. No question about it. Whether we acknowledge or whether we deny, whether we brush death under the carpet, whether the topic of death or dying does not appeal to us, we are going to die sooner or later. So isn't it better that we are well prepared for this day when it comes? That our hereafter is not the day of judgment. Each and everyone's hereafter starts or begins from the time when the soul departs from the body, and then it goes through the heavenly journey, and then it joins the body in the grave, and then you live in the grave for as long as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills until the day of judgment. So there is a life of barzakh, transition, in between. When you travel from here to the Far East, you stop over in the Middle East for transit, few hours, and then you catch another flight to continue your flight, continue your journey. Life in the grave is like that transit period that you spend at the airport waiting to take a connection flight. Except that it may be much longer. We do not know. We do not know when the day of judgment will be, but we know the day of judgment will be, it's Friday. Yes, the day of judgment will take place on Friday. All the creation in the morning from Fajr time, listen attentively, fearing that the angel will sound the trumpet. All the animals, all the birds, all the insects, except jinns and the humans. We are not in tune with time as it goes by. But every Friday morning, from dawn time until sunrise, all the creation listen attentively, fearing that could this Friday be the day? Except us. The day of judgment will take place on Friday. This is the day Allah created Adam. This is the day Allah sent Adam to earth. This is the day Adam passed away, alayhi salam. This is the day when the angel will sound the trumpet. That's the day of judgment. It is very imminent. Even the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam anticipated the day of judgment at his time, more than 1400 years ago. What did he say, Rasulullah? كَيْفَ أَنْعَمُوا وَقَدْ الْتَقَمَ صَاحِبُ الْقَرْنِ قَرْنَهُ وَحَنَى جَبْهَتَهُ وَشَخَصَ بِبَصَرِهِ مَخَافَةَ أَنْ يُؤْمَرَ قَبْلَ أَنْ يَرْتَدَّ إِلَيْهِ طَرْفُهُ. ما معنى هذا؟ كيف أنعم وقد التقم صاحب الكون كونه؟ أي أن الملك الموكل بالنفخ في الصور وهو إسرافيل عليه السلام قد أمسك بالقرن وهو الصور، وشخص ببصره، حنى جبهته وشخص ببصره ينظر إلى عرش الرحمن سبحانه وتعالى، ومخافة أن يؤمر بأن ينفخ في الصور وهو يغمض عينه. تخيلوا إلى هذا الحد كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يحذر الصحابة من قرب قيام يوم القيامة. فلما اشتد على الصحابة قالوا ماذا نقول يا رسول الله؟ قال قولوا حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل، على الله توكلنا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, how can I enjoy life and the angel who is appointed to sound the trumpet, Israfil عليه السلام, has held the trumpet in his hands, has bent his back, his neck, and pointing with his eyes. His eyes are like shining stars, looking at Allah's throne, fearing that he may blink. And during this time, the order may come from Allah to sound the trumpet, i.e., it is imminent. It is imminent, it's very close. But life, materialistics of life, overwhelm our lives and digress, cause us to digress from the path of going towards meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the nature of humans. But be more focused and think that this day will come and you will stand before Allah. Two nights, most of the early Muslims and the pious Muslims feared the most. One night is the first night when your body is laid in the grave. That's the first night you spend the night not in your comfortable bed, not in the room where there is heating and facilities and bathroom. No. First night when you are laid, when your body is laid in the grave on your own. Strange, unfamiliar environment. You will be there on your own. Are you prepared for this day when it comes? It will come sooner or later. We do not know when. But look forward to that day when it comes. The second night that early Muslims feared the most is the night before. The night before the day. The night before the day of judgment. When you will be told, because the day of judgment will take place on the day, halummu ila rabbikum. Stand before your Lord. Stand before Allah. Get ready to stand before Allah. So imagine you will be raised up, inshallah, that day. Amongst how many? What is the world's population now? It's nearly 7 billion. So let alone from the time of Adam alayhi salam until end of this world, not only humans will be raised up, jinns will be raised up, animals, birds, insects, anything with soul. وَإِذَا الْوُحُوشُ حُشْرَ. All the animals will be raised up on that day. All the creation will stand on one flat surface. So if the world's population now is 7 billion, nearly 7 billion, and from the day, time of Adam until the end of the world, how many? And you will be there on your own, standing, not forgotten. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never forget anyone. وَمَا كَانَ رَبُّكَ نَسِيَّ. Allah never forgets, because that's why He is Allah. He is the Lord, He is the King of the kings. He is the creator, He is the maker, He is the sustainer. He is the one who gives rizq. He is the one who takes life. Who is the one who gives life. Hence, He will never forget anyone. إِن كُلُّ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِلَّا آتِ الرَّحْمَنِ عَبْدًا لَقَدْ أحصاهم وعدهم عدا وكلهم آتيه يوم القيامة فردا. سبحان الله. الله سبحانه وتعالى will never forget anyone. He has counted them one by one. None will be forgotten. None will be forgotten on the day of judgment. لقد أحصاهم وعدهم عدا وكلهم آتيه يوم القيامة فردا. Each and everyone will stand before Allah on his own. That day, يوم يفر المرء من أخيه وأمه وأبيه وصاحبته وبنيه. Each and everyone will be concerned about his own self. Not his wife, not his son, not his daughter, not his family. Each and everyone will be just concerned about his own self. Not thinking, يوم تضع كل ذات حمل حملها وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى. When the woman will miscarry, because of the horror of that day, the hardship of that day, you'll see these people as if they are in a drunken riot, in a state, but they are not drunk. But it is the fear, it is the horror, it is the changes that will happen to this universe. It's the hardship of the day of judgment. That what prompted Anas radiallahu anhu to ask the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, أتشفع لي يا رسول الله؟ قال نعم إن شاء الله. Will you make شفاعة? Will you ask for intercession for on my behalf? Yes, I will. And Anas asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how can I meet you on the day of judgment? This is Anas's question to the Prophet. Anas fears that on his own he won't do any good without the Prophet's help. How can I meet you, Prophet of Allah? Yes, he wants to meet the Prophet on the day of judgment. The Prophet ﷺ said, meet me where the scale is, al-mizan. What if I miss you near the scale? Meet me near as-sirat, the path. What if I miss you there? Meet me where the pond, al-hawd, that the Prophet ﷺ is given. Where are these places? Al-mizan. ونضع الموازين القسط ليوم القيامة فلا تظلم نفس شيئا وإن كان مثقال حبة من خردل أتينا بها وكفى بنا حاسبين. We will put the scales. Scales on the day of judgment, or the scale has got two sides. Exactly like in the olden days when they used to have the scale, hold it like this, and one side here and one side there. But this scale is different. If the whole of the heavens and the earth were put on the scale will accommodate for this. ونضع الموازين القسط ليوم القيامة فلا تظلم نفس شيئا. No soul will be dealt with unjustly. وإن كان مثقال حبة من خردل, if an atom's weight of anything as small as any smallest, the smallest thing, we will bring it. وكفى بنا حاسبين. هذا كتابنا ينطق بالحق إنا كنا نستنسخ ما كنتم تعملون. This is our book. It has all. It's full of the truth. We used to write down what we used to do. We are not left alone in this world. Move forward, brothers, please, to make room in the back, please. Close all the gaps here. Come closer, please. We are not alone in this world. Each and everyone has got two noble angels who accompany him or her day and night. Most of the 24 hours. Except at times when you go to the bathroom, except at times when you have intimacy with the wife. Hence, these times, you should not talk. Otherwise, the angels will have to write what you talk and you sort of put them in an awkward position. Hence, we are not alone. We have been under surveillance. Two noble angels will write exactly what we say and what we do. Comes the day of judgment. هذا كتابنا ينطق بالحق. This is our book, stating the truth. We used to write down what we used to do. Whatever you say, whatever you do, will be written down. أحصاه الله ونسوه. Allah make records of this, but they forgotten. They had forgotten. And comes the day of judgment, your book of deeds will be there. اقرأ كتابك. Read your own book. كفى بنفسك اليوم عليك حسيبا. Suffice that you are the one to review his own deeds. Absolute justice of Allah. كفى بنفسك. You are the one to review his deeds, not a wife, not a son, not a relative, not a close friend. No. That's what prompted Anas رضي الله عنه. How can I ensure that I will see you, Prophet of Allah, on the day of judgment? Not just asking for the shafa'ah, although the shafa'ah itself is a huge achievement. The only one who will be given permission to speak on the day of judgment is, without any pride, is our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. No other prophet will talk, none of the other prophets. فَلَا تَسْمَعُ إِلَّا هَمْسَةً. People are whispering. People will be whispering. مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يَشْفَعُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِهِ. Who can ask for intercession except with Allah's permission? The Prophet, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not Prophet Adam alayhi salam, who was created by Allah's hands, blew the soul into his body and made the angels bow before him, prostrate before him. Not Prophet Nuh alayhi salam, سَمَّاهُ اللَّهُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا, that's his name. Not Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, who was Allah's friend, وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا. Not Prophet Musa alayhi salam, whom Allah spoke to, Kalimullah. Not Prophet Isa, Ruhullah wa kalimatuhu. It would be Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Don't you want to be granted shafa'ah on the day of judgment by the Prophet? How can we ensure that the Prophet will ask for shafa'ah for us? Whenever you hear the adhan, اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة القائمة آت محمدا الوسيلة والفضل. All the dua that you should memorize by heart and say it after the adhan. Once you hear the adhan, say this dua. If you don't know it by heart, write it down. Until you memorize it, Prophet Shafa'ah will be granted to you on the day of judgment, inshallah. So memorize this dua. Always say it whenever you hear the adhan. So the Prophet ﷺ will meet, Anas will try to meet up with the Prophet near the scale, al-mizan. What if he misses the Prophet near the scale? Where will he meet up with him? Meet me عند الصراط, the path. What is الصراط? الصراط is a very thin passage that each and everyone will have to cross. Its length is about 1 month journey. Its edge is sharper than the edge of the sword. It is thinner than one single hair. That is a sirat. Some will travel at the sirat at the speed of, you name it, speed of sound. No time at all. Some will travel at the speed of the wind. Some will travel at the speed of a fast horse running. Some will be running. Some will be crawling. And some will fall. Underneath a sirat is the hellfire. The hellfire will have hooks, and wal'iyadu billah, it may drag a person. How will we travel? It is very dark. But your light, the light, نورهم يسعى بين أيديهم وبأيمانهم. Believers will have light ahead of them to lead them to travel across the sirat. And depends on how good you are, the light will be leading you. Some will have just full light ahead of them, hence they will cross the sirat very quickly. And some will have lesser and lesser light. And some will have light just the size of his big toe. That is the light that will be leading this person. Hence, that person may fall, wal'iyadu billah. The fire may catch him. So, pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable us to pass on the sirat peacefully and calmly. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be there. He will be saying, Ya Rabbi Sallim, Ya Rabbi Sallim. The Prophet will be there near a sirat. So Anas, if I miss you near the sirat, Prophet of Allah, where can I meet up with you? Meet me where the pond, Al-Hawd. What is Al-Hawd? It's a beautiful pond of water, more delicious than honey, whiter than milk, and the cups, the glasses, the number of these will be like the stars in the heavens. Whoever has one drink of that water will never be thirsty. if you drink, if the Prophet ﷺ gives you a drink on the Day of Judgment, from this pond, from this al-hawt, you will never be thirsty. أدعو الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يسقينا من حوض نبيه شربة هنيئة مريئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا إن شاء الله. So that is al-hawt. That is Anas keen to meet his beloved Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. How about you? How about me? How about us? Don't you wish to meet the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم on the Day of Judgment? Don't you want to be in the company of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and the companions and the pious and the martyrs? Don't you want to have the comfort, serenity, tranquility when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala covers you by His shade, when the sun will be very close to the people's heads and they will perspire, they will sweat in an enormous amount? On that day, some will be covered by Allah's shade. Some will come on the Day of Judgment, will be calm and comfortable in serenity, in tranquility. But don't fear that day. You are going to meet a Lord who is ever forgiven, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why never despair of Allah's mercy. If you make a mistake, follow it by a good deed. اتبع السيئة الحسنة تمحوها. Follow a bad deed with a good deed, it will remove it. But Allah says in Surah Al-Furqan, إِلَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ. Except those who repent, believe, and do righteous deeds. Allah will transform their bad deeds into good deeds on the Day of Judgment. Comes the Day of Judgment, your book will be opened. Where are my bad deeds? They have disappeared. Where are they? By Allah's grace and mercy, He has transformed all these bad deeds into good deeds. And comes the Day of Judgment, here's your book. Take it by your right hand, not by the left hand. If you are given your book, when people are standing, waiting, when the books will be flying, not knowing whether your book will land on you in your right side or on the left side. If you are given your book by the right hand, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينَهُ فَيَقُولُ هَا أُمُكْرَأُ كِتَابِيَهُ إِنِّي ظَنَنْتُ أَنِّي مُلَاقٍ حِسَابِيَهُ فَهُوَ فِي عِيشَةٍ رَاضِيَةٍ فِي جَنَّةٍ عَالِيَةٍ قُطُوفُهَا دَانِيَةٍ كُلُوا وَاشْرَبُوا هَنِيئًا بِمَا أَسْلَفْتُمْ فِي الْأَيَّامِ الْخَالِيَةِ. That is if you are given your book by the right side. Good news. Take your book and straight to paradise. Go and enjoy yourself over there for the hard work that you had in this life, for the dedication, for the continuous prayers, for fasting, for doing righteous deeds, for being kind to each other, respecting each other, humbling to each other, yourself to each other, for the good deeds, the hard time, the dedication, the commitment in this world that will lead you to enjoy and relax in paradise. No more prayers in paradise. No more fasting in paradise. Just enjoy food, drink, wives, etc., etc. So, من أحب لقاء الله أحب الله لقاءه ومن كره لقاء الله كره الله لقاءه. Whoever looks forward to meeting Allah, Allah will look forward to meeting him. Whoever does not look forward to meeting Allah, Allah won't like meeting him. Sayyidah Aisha asked the Prophet ﷺ, O Prophet of Allah, we all hate death. We don't like death because it's unknown, it's unfamiliar. Any unfamiliar circumstance will be frightening. The whole of the hereafter is al-ghayb, unseen. We do not know its nature. Hence, it is frightening. The Prophet ﷺ said, it is not that, Aisha. But when the believer is told of what's ahead, Allah has mercy, Allah has rewards, Allah has paradise, he will look forward and she will look forward to meeting Allah, and Allah will look forward to meeting him or her. Allahumma ja'alna mimman yuhibbuna liqa'ak, wa la taj'alna mimman yakrahuna liqa'ak. Allahumma adhillana fi dhilla 'arshika yawma la dhilla illa dhilluh. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. لله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد, my dear brothers and sisters, we are going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala one day. We should always be prepared for this day when it comes. Don't be taken by surprise. Start today. Start today. Increase your record of good deeds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He wrote, as the Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَتَبَ الْحَسَنَاتِ وَالسَّيِّئَاتِ ثُمَّ بَيَّنَ ذَلِكَ. فمن هم بحسنة فلم يعملها كتبت له حسنة كاملة، فإن عملها كتبت له بعشرة أضعاف إلى 700 ضعف إلى ما شاء الله. ومن هم بسيئة فلم يعملها كتبت له حسنة كاملة، فإن عملها كتبت له سيئة واحدة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Allah سبحانه وتعالى has made حسنات, good deeds, and سيئات, bad deeds, and made it clear, clarified this. Whoever intends to do a good deed, but he never does it, will be written as if he has done it. He will get one reward. Say, for example, you intended to read Quran, but you never got around to read it, for whatever reasons, but intention was good. You will get rewarded for this. You intended to give for charity, but you couldn't. You intended to visit a patient, but you couldn't. Intention was there for a good cause, you will get rewarded. If you do the hasana, if you do the good deed, you will get 10 times, 700 times, up to even multiples of 700. And whoever intends to do a bad deed, and he never does it, will be written as one hasana, one good deed. And if he does it, will be written as one single bad deed. Look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala treats us. One equals 10, up to 700, even more. One bad deed is only one bad deed. It's not multiples of the one bad deed. So that's why you are going to meet a Lord who is ever forgiven, oft merciful, will meet you with earth full of forgiveness if you meet him not associating partners with Allah. If you meet Allah not ascribing partners with Allah, but with an earth full of sins and mistakes, Allah will meet you with earth full of rewards and forgiveness. But paradise is not one level. Paradise, al-Jannah, is 100 levels. Between each level and the next is what's between the earth and the heaven. So make your choice. When you pray to Allah, aim for the highest, the best, the most middle place in paradise, which is Al-Firdaus. Don't be contented with anything less than Al-Firdaus. When you ask Allah, ask of Al-Firdaus. It is the highest place, it is the most middle place. From Al-Firdaus flow the rivers of paradise. Above Al-Firdaus is Arsh al-Rahman, Allah's throne. So aim to enter into paradise. أدعو الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يغفر لنا ذنوبنا ويسكننا فسيح جناته إن شاء الله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. اللهم ارزقنا حبك وحب من يحبك وحب عمل يقربنا إلى حبك يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارزقنا الجنة وكل ما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل، وباعد بيننا وبين النار وكل ما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. اللهم ارزقنا حبك وحب من يحبك وحب عمل يقربنا إلى حبك يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها. اللهم خذ أعداء الإسلام أخذ عزيز مقتدر. اللهم شتت شملهم وبدد جمعهم واجعل الدائرة عليهم يا رب العالمين. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه. Before I finish, there's an announcement here. Announcement. I spoke to you in the past about the youth club. Inshallah, it will be up and running very soon.